Welcome to Understand the Math. Before you begin, be sure to check out the video description for a link to a blank unit circle and guided notes that you can download and fill in as you watch this video. In this video, I'll present a simple and quick way to memorize the degrees, radians, and coordinate points on the unit circle. Let's begin memorizing the unit circle by first memorizing the degrees. A circle contains 360 degrees. There are four quadrants in a circle, so each quadrant contains 360 degrees divided by 4, which gives us 90 degrees. To memorize the degrees, we're going to start at 0 degrees, work counterclockwise around the unit circle, and count by 90 degrees, then by 30 degrees, then by 45 degrees. We'll indicate the 90 degree counting in red, the 30 degree counting in purple, and then the 45 degree counting in light blue. We'll begin at 0 degrees and count by 90. 0 degrees plus 90 degrees is 90 degrees. 90 plus 90 is 180 degrees. 180 degrees plus 90 is 270 degrees. And then if we add 90 to 270, we get 360 degrees, which is the same as 0. Let's now count by 30 degrees. We start at 0 degrees, add 30 degrees. Then we have 30 degrees plus 30 degrees gives us 60 degrees. 60 plus 30 is 90, which we already have at the top. 90 plus 30 is 120 degrees. 120 plus 30 is 150 degrees. 150 plus 30 is 180 degrees, which we already have on the left-hand side. We now start with 180 and we add 30. And we get 210 degrees, add 30 to 210, and we get 240 degrees. 240 plus 30 is 270, which we already have down at the bottom. 270 plus 30 is 300 degrees, and then 300 plus 30 is 330 degrees. Adding 30 degrees again gets us back to 360 degrees, which we already have. Let's finish by counting by 45 degrees. We start at 0 degrees, add 45, so we get up to 45 degrees. 45 degrees plus 45 degrees is 90 degrees, which we already have. 90 plus 45 is 135 degrees. 135 degrees plus 45 degrees is 180 degrees, which we already have. 180 plus 45 gives us 225 degrees. 225 plus 45 gets us 270, which is already there. 270 plus 45 gets us 315 degrees. And then if we were to add 45 again, we would get back up to 360 degrees. In this diagram are all the degrees that need to be memorized on the unit circle. A circle contains 2 pi radians. There are 4 quadrants in a circle, so each quadrant contains 2 pi divided by 4, which is pi over 2 radians. To memorize the radians, we're going to start at 0 and count by pi over 2, then pi over 6, then pi over 4. We'll begin at 0 and count by pi over 2. So we have 0, adding pi over 2 gets us to the top. Pi over 2 plus pi over 2 gives us pi. Pi plus pi over 2 gets us 3 pi over 2. Adding pi over 2 again gets us back to 2 pi, which is 0 degrees. Let's now count by pi over 6. 0 plus pi over 6 is pi over 6. pi over 6 plus pi over 6 is 2 pi over 6, which is pi over 3. You always want to reduce your fractions. 2 pi over 6, notice I said 2 pi over 6 and not pi over 3. 2 pi over 6 plus pi over 6 is 3 pi over 6, which we don't really need to write down, but it will help in getting to the next point. 3 pi over 6 plus pi over 6 is 4 pi over 6, which is 2 pi over 3. 4 pi over 6 plus pi over 6 is 5 pi over 6. And then 5 pi over 6 plus pi over 6 is 6 pi over 6, which is pi, which we already have. 6 pi over 6 plus pi over 6 is 7 pi over 6. 7 pi over 6 plus pi over 6 is 8 pi over 6, which is 4 pi over 3. 8 pi over 6 plus pi over 6 is 9 pi over 6. And you don't really need to write these down. It just helps. Maybe you could just keep them in your head to get to the next point. 9 pi over 6 plus pi over 6 is 10 pi over 6, which reduces to 5 pi over 3. And then lastly, 10 pi over 6 plus pi over 6 gives us 11 pi over 6. And then you can see if we were to add pi over 6 again, we would get back to 2 pi or 0. Lastly, we're going to count by pi over 4. 0 plus pi over 4 gives us pi over 4. Pi over 4 plus pi over 4 gets us to pi over 2. Pi over 2 plus pi over 4 gives us 3 pi over 4. 3 pi over 4 plus pi over 4 gets us down to pi. Pi plus pi over 4 is 5 pi over 4. Adding pi over 4 again gets us down to the bottom at 3 pi over 2. And then our last one, 3 pi over 2 or 6 pi over 4 plus pi over 4 gets us to 7 pi over 4. Adding pi over 4 again gets us to 2 pi. These are all the radians that you will need to memorize on the unit circle. The last part we need to memorize is the quadrant signs and coordinate points. There are four steps that we're going to follow. I'm not going to be able to capture the steps and the circle all in the same page, but I will talk about each step as we go along. Let's start with step one. We need to fill in the quadrants and quadrant signs. Our first quadrant is located in the upper right corner of the circle. And in this quadrant, both x and y are positive, so we'll indicate this with a plus, comma, plus. Our second quadrant is located in the upper left quarter of the circle. In this quadrant, x is negative and y is positive, so we'll indicate that by a minus plus. Our third quadrant is located in the lower left quarter of the circle. In this quadrant, both x and y are negative, so we'll indicate that with a minus minus. Lastly, our fourth quadrant is located in the lower right quarter of our circle. In this quadrant, x is positive and y is negative, and we'll indicate that by a plus minus. Let's now complete step two and fill in the quadrant points. We'll begin with 1, 0 and go counterclockwise around the circle. So our first point is 1, 0. Up at the top is our point 0, 1. On the left-hand side is our point minus 1, 0. And at the bottom is our point 0, -1. To complete step three, we're going to fill in the coordinate points in the first quadrant. As we go from 1, 0 up to 0, 1, x is going to go from 1 to 0 and y is going to go from 0 to 1. We're going to think of 1, 0 as the square root of 4/2, comma square root of 0/2. And I'll show you at the end why this is going to help us. we're going to think of our next point as the square root of 3 over 2, and then the square root of 1 over 2. And this gives us the point root 3 over 2, comma 1 half. The next point we're going to think of as root 2 over 2, root 2 over 2. And that is going to stay just like that when we rewrite it in black. So this is root 2 over 2, comma root 2 over 2. This next point we're going to think of as the square root of 1 over 2, comma square root of 3 over 2. And we'll rewrite that as 1 half, comma root 3 over 2. And then our last point we're going to think of as square root of 0 over 2, comma, square root of 4 over 2. Now I'm going to highlight some values so that you can see why we did the writing that we did in blue. The y value is going to start at 0 and then go to 1, 2, 3, 4. And then the x value is going to start at 4, or square root of 4 over 2, which is 1. And then go to 3, 2, 1, and then 0. In our last step, which is step 4, we're going to use symmetry and quadrant signs to fill in the other three quadrants. To fill in quadrant 2, we move the point from the first quadrant across to the second quadrant, like this. We'll then change our x value to negative, and our y value stays the same. So our first point is minus 1 half, comma, root 3 over 2. We're going to do that same pattern. So our next point is going to be minus root 2 over 2, comma, root 2 over 2. Our next value is minus root 3 over 2, 1 half. And then our last value is minus 1, 0, which is already there. To fill in quadrant 3, we move the point on the second quadrant down to the third quadrant, like this, and we're going to change the y to negative. Our x value stays negative. So our first point is minus root 3 over 2 minus a half. Our next point is minus root 2 over 2 minus root 2 over 2. And our last point is going to be minus a half, minus root 3 over 2. To fill in quadrant 4, we move the point on the third quadrant to the right, like this, and we change x to positive, and our y value stays negative. So our first point is 1 half, minus root 3 over 2. Our next point is root 2 over 2 minus root 2 over 2. And then our very last point is root 3 over 2, comma, minus 1 half. Those are all the points that you'll need to memorize. If you follow the steps outlined in this video and practice filling out the unit circle, you'll be able to memorize it pretty quickly. You can do this. If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.